Hello friends, I'm Shaurya Mishra. Welcome you to your own YouTube channel, Vision Care Advisor. Friends, in this video, we will discuss about ametropia and emetropia. The difference between these two, ametropia and emetropia. So, without taking much time, let's get started. So firstly, let's talk about ametropia. Ametropia are considered when the refractive error is present. So, when the parallel rays of light coming from infinity are not brought to focus at the sensitive layer of the retina, when accommodation is at rest. It means the rays of light coming from infinity are focused either in front or behind the retina, in one meridian or both the meridian. For example, myopia, hypermetropia, and astigmatism. So, myopia, hypermetropia, and astigmatism are considered under ametropia. We will discuss more about the myopia, hypermetropia, and astigmatism in next coming videos shortly. So let's know about the emetropia. Emetropia are considered when the refractive error is not present. It means an emetropic eye is perfectly in focus for distance and does not require glasses to see far away. So when the parallel rays of light coming from infinity are brought to focus at the sensitive layer of the retina when accommodation is at rest. So friends, let's see why we are always considering that accommodation should be at rest either it is in emetropia or ametropia. Friends, if our eyes accommodate, then what will happen in emetropia? So, the retinal image in emetropia moves forward away from the retina, resulting a circle of blur on the retina, and this produces mild to moderate myopia, causing diminishing in distance vision. An emetropic eye accommodates for near as per age, means lesser the age, more is accommodation. As we all know that kids have strong accommodation. Similarly, when the object is closer, accordingly, more accommodation is required. So let's know more about the normal values of an emetropic eye briefly. Friends, the anteroposterior length from anterior surface of the cornea to the retina is 24 mm. It is considered 23.5 mm horizontally and 23 mm vertically. The average diameter of cornea is 11 mm vertically and 12 mm horizontally. It makes cornea more curved in vertical meridian. An average curvature of the cornea is 7.8 mm. The central 3 mm of the cornea is more spherical than the periphery. The total dioptic power of an emetropic eye is plus 60 diopter. The parallel rays are focused on the photosensitive layer of the retina when accommodation is at rest. The unaided values means without any power and without refractive errors, vision should be 6/6. Media of the eye are clear and fundus is normal, can be considered an emetropic eye. In an emetropic eye, the angle kappa is 5 degree positive. An emetropic eye is generally orthophoric but can be also heterophoric or heterotropic. The accommodation of an emetropic eye varies according to the age. It means it is more in young people as compared to old people. Near point also varies with age. In early presbyopic, it is about 30 cm and gradually increases with age. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more updates. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Please do remember to check your vision yearly and see the world clearly.